Dear students, today we will be learning a chapter called friction. Now, what do you mean by friction? It's very simple to hear because you heard that word, but actually you don't know how to tell. You open the book and read. Actually, the definition what it says, friction is the force, obstructional force created in between two moving objects. Or it's a resistance between two surfaces. Why I am telling? Because the first definition only, which is clear definition, always a frictional force created in between two moving objects. It's an obstructional force between two moving surfaces called friction. Why I will tell you? Because we need much more than that also. There are two, three types also. A type static and limiting, three dynamic. In dynamic there are three types, two types again, sliding and rolling. Now why I am telling? Because see, friction can be, in engineering field we say friction is a bad property, but it is not bad. It is highly advantageous. In the general terms, if you say without friction we cannot live. What happened? Why it is necessary? See, to stand it is necessary, to sit it is necessary, to count the notes it is necessary, to hold the chalk it is necessary, to hold the pen it is necessary. Everywhere, even if you want to take water from the well, it is, the friction is necessary. Without friction it will slip. You can't walk. You can't ride, you can't stop the vehicle. I can give you lakh of examples, advantage. But one big disadvantage is wear and tear. Because of friction, what happens is the moving parts always slowly wear off. You can't eliminate wear off, but you can reduce wear off by using lubricant. Or you may be making the surface very smooth. But you can't eliminate. But only thing, the wear and tear, the duration of wear and tear can be prolonged. That much is possible, that theoretically, let it be. Next part, very importantly in friction there are three types. One is called static. Static means without any movement. For example, we are sitting on the chair. Say I am standing, I am not moving. But there is a friction in between. Now that is called static. Limiting. Limiting friction means, for example, see this is the surface. See, now it is a flat surface, the object is there on the table. Now, see, for example, see it is, for example, now it is, because it is a round object, it is rolling. See, it is about to move. Now, when you increase the angle, it is sliding. It is about to slide means, at that particular time, what the friction created in between is called limiting friction. Now, once after it started moving, this is called dynamic. There are two things. One is sliding. When I keep the round object, it will roll. See? Now this is rolling. If it is a round object, it is rolling. But even in rolling, there is friction. Even in sliding, there is friction. Amount of friction may be different. In rolling, it may be less. In sliding, it may be more. Now, next part comes. In this chapter, we have to learn one important thing called coefficient of friction. It's also called as mu. Now, what do you mean by that? Now, this surface, if you keep the object, see, always weight is going to fall downwards. Now, when the weight is there, there is a reaction called R, normal reaction. Now, when you pull or push with a force, always it is going to obstruct from the other side, that is called frictional force. From the other side it is going to obstruct. One side you are pulling, because it is rubbing in between, there is a force called frictional force. That is why we can write frictional F by W or frictional force by normal reaction. Now that is the relationship between, mu means it's the relationship between these two things. F or W or relationship between frictional force by normal reaction. With that, see, we got a formula. Now, this is the formula. Another thing is angle of inclination. Second thing which you have to learn. It's also very simple. After calculating this, now before that I will tell you, see, this has got no unit. Why no unit? It's a pure number. It has got no unit. Because both, this also will be in kg. This also will be in kg. Both gets cancelled. Both gets cancelled. That's why the coefficient of friction doesn't have any unit. One thing which should be very clear. The next part, angle of inclination. Look at here. This angle of inclination, what happens here? The formula is tan theta is equal to mu. Mu already you have calculated. Mu already put the value of mu, you will get tan theta. After that, now theta can be calculated by taking the tan value. That will be so many degrees. Angle will be so many degrees. To represent that, I have done a problem here. Look at here. The first sum. In the example, the first sum happened on the board. See, first sum you see that force, pulling force, or it can be called as force, P, or it can be called as force, or it can be called as frictional force. It is how much? 40 kg. Weight, or normal reaction, it is how much? 400 kg. Both is in kg, is it not? Now, this you have to observe. Both the unit should be in the same unit. If it is in pound, this also should be in pound. After that, mu is equal to how much? Calculate mu. Formula you all know. Mu is equal to F by W. Or it can be frictional force by normal reaction. Or it can be P by W. Whatever it is. Okay? So it gets 0.1. You got the answer 0.1. Coefficient of friction is 0.1. Next, if they ask angle of inclination, then you must be able to calculate that. Tan theta, in the first sum it is not asked, I am explaining. Tan theta is equal to mu. The value of mu you put it here. So, 0.1. Tan theta is 0.1. Theta means, this already I have calculated how to take. From the calculator only can take tan value. Theta is equal to 5 degree, 48 minutes. So, there are 15 to 20 examples are there. And little assignment is also there. Do all that. And write it in notes, keep it ready. Tomorrow I may take a class on center of gravity. Read that and keep it ready. Thank you.